American satisfaction with this position in the world is at its highest level since 2005. This is according to a Gallup poll. 45% of Americans are satisfied with the where the United States stands. That's a 13% increase from just a year ago. Here now with us to discuss, David Bahnsen, the Bahnsen Group founder and CIO, also author of Crisis of Responsibility, and a National Review contributor, Gail Trotter, attorney, contributor to The Hill, and back with us, Hugo Gurdon. Let me start with you, Gail. That's a remarkable number. It's, you know, if you look at the chart, it was sort of just listing away and drifting and drifting, and all of a sudden this new groundswell of optimism or appreciation for where we stand amongst our peers in the world is, well, we stand above them. What do you make of it?
That's right. Well, it is interesting that now that we have a president who's putting America first and actually making decisions on the world stage that actually benefit America instead of trying to be this global citizen, you're seeing it is inversely proportionate to Americans being more satisfied with the job that he's doing and world leaders being less satisfied. And is it any surprise that those two numbers are inversely proportionate?
David, and the same kind of Gallup poll, you know, the rest of the world does views us in a very negative light. But let's not forget, President Obama started his presidency with a sort of an apology tour to the rest of the world. And of course, they embraced him. They loved that idea. And you have another now you have a new president saying, no. He unabashedly is saying America first. And it may recall the tales of the ugly American abroad, but here at home, it's making us feel pretty good.
Yeah, I think that there's a couple of factors at play. I don't think you can ignore the economic aspect. I mean, you're certainly right that the Obama apology tour was related to foreign policy. It was at the heels of this unpopular Iraq war. There had been a lot of complications in it. But really, I think right now, Americans see the fact that our free market system, for all of its flaws, and really the flaws are mostly just our leaders' inability to implement it as the free enterprise system we were born to be as a country.
Right.
But you look at Europe in a much different economic position. They're starting to get a little growth. Japan has been in this deflationary spiral for 25 plus years. I think that Americans are able to see that our free enterprise system does give us that exceptional superiority on a global stage.
Hugo, what do you make of it?
I think that one of the things that you're saying, I agree with the other panelists here, but what America... what Americans like is almost precisely the thing that what some foreign people do dislike. Under President Obama, a lot of our allies and indeed our enemies used to be able to take the United States for granted. Our allies would assume that we'd be in the Paris Accord, for example, on climate change. And when President Obama warned that there was a red line in Syria where he wouldn't allow chemical weapons to be used, our enemies and opponents just crossed that red line with impunity. What's happened now in the last year is that there's now a president who is showing that America cannot be taken for granted. He actually attacked Syria when chemical weapons were used, and guess what happened? They haven't been used again. And he decided to pull out of the Paris Accord. So no one, whether they're our allies or our enemies, is any longer taking the United States for granted. That makes Americans feel good, and that makes the foreigners feel more cautious.
In addition to that, though, Gail, it feels like also this is the kind of thing, you know, the President Trump is the antithesis, if you will, of what the elites in this country want, what the mainstream media in this country, the more they hate him, it feels like the more Americans themselves, though, feel proud of the accomplishments that have come so far under his presidency.
That's right, because you remember a big theme of his campaign was thinking about the forgotten man and the forgotten woman. And President Trump has a unique ability to go and be with the billionaire, the globalists, and speak their language. But he can take the message of the forgotten man and the forgotten woman to the global elites. And we saw President Obama was trying so hard to advance the global principles, and yet President Trump will not cede those bedrock principles.
Right. David.
I think that one aspect we can't ignore when we talk about the foreign policy and even our economic strength is cultural. I think that a lot of the people around the world that dislike America don't like what we stand for. I think that you will see that number, American satisfaction with our global standing, go higher and world ratings of us go lower the stronger we get culturally, the more we defend the principles and values that have made us Americans. We have work to do there.
Even if the result is sort of a Pax Americana where the whole world benefits from our increased strength and our increased economic and military strength, they'll still have a southern underlying resentment.
I think that that's been the case historically, but that is a little less true with some Western countries. But Europe right now has been the wild card.
All right, guys. Thank you all very much.